In this episode of John's Arcade, we're going back to the garage. That's right, we're gonna do part number 5 of the Rockola Jump Bug restoration. Then we're gonna come back to the table and do some viewer mail. And then also, guys, I need to remind you, May 29th and 30th, 2015, I'm putting on a tournament at Fun Spot. That's right, it's called John's Arcade Impossible Outsiders Tournament. All the details you need to know are at johnsarcade.com. All right, guys. Let's get on with the show. Hey guys, we are in the basement and today we're gonna do part number 5. That is right, part number 5 of the Rockola Jump Bug restoration. And in this video, we're gonna do a lot of busy work because in this video, I need to take care of all those metal parts. You know, like the coin door, and the brackets that hold the marquee on. There's some brackets around the control panel. And then also in this video, we're gonna rebuild the control panel. We're gonna clean that thing up because that thing is filthy, filthy, filthy. And I also wanna rebuild that 8-way Wico joystick because there's an original Wico joystick on there that has like a grommet in there. So we're gonna take that all apart and clean it up, replace the grommet, and make it like new and probably sand all the rust and all that good stuff. And then also in this video, I wanna change some skate bearings. You guys mind if we do that? So I thought it'd be fun. We'll change some bearings on a skateboard. I know, but you know, I just kind of wanted to do it. So anyway, enough of that. Let's get to the garage and let's get to work on that Rockola Jump Bug. All right, guys, we're back in the garage. Did you miss me? I know, we weren't in the garage last week. I had to take it off for Mother's Day. But anyway, we're back out here. And we're gonna attack the Jump Bug. In the last Jump Bug video, we rebuilt the 4600 monitor that's in here, and we got the game working. It is playable, and actually, I've been playing the game quite a bit in the garage. I have to tell you, I think Jump Bug is an awesome game. It is one of these just like lost classics that time has forgot. And if you have MAME, I really strongly urge you to boot this game up and play it because it's actually a ton of fun. And the more I play it, actually my buddy Matt McCarthy was here the other night and we were playing it all night. And Matt actually finished the game because there is like an ending. It actually ends and then it starts over at level 1 again, but he got past the last level. And really, the more we played it, the more we realized there's all kinds of little ways to like get extra points and point pressing. And the game's actually surprisingly deep and there's just lots of little like hidden secrets and stuff. And just check it out. It is a cool ass game. So anyway, what we're gonna do in this video is I wanna start attacking the metal parts. I wanna rebuild the control panel and the joystick because this joystick is just loosey-goosey. We're gonna see if we're gonna replace the, we might replace the grommet depending on the condition. I suspect this thing's completely blown out because, I mean, there's like no resistance. It's just loose, loose, loose. And I have some new grommets, so we're gonna look at that. I want to paint all the metal parts, you know, and possibly the coin door too. The metal parts up here, you know, we're going to paint all those, sand them down. And we might get to the blue in this video because the plan is this. We're going to spray paint the blue, okay? And I actually got a new color that I think is pretty good. I picked up this color here. It's called Brilliant Blue, okay? And I spray painted some on the front here, if you guys can see. And so I've actually tried 3 different colors, okay? So the first color I tried was like right here, and it's just way too dark, okay? And that color was this one right here, which is Oxford Blue Satin. Wasn't good, just too dark and just dull right here. And then I tried this paint right here, okay, which is this one, which is Gloss Deep Blue, okay? It's a gloss, it's not ideal, I really want satin, but you know, as far as blue colors go in spray paint, really, gloss is your best. You have more options with gloss. And originally, this was just spray painted. They probably used a gun, you know, more, a little more refined technique probably than using spray cans, but whatever. So I found this color here, Gloss Brilliant Blue, which I sprayed right here. And you could see this is actually a really good match. And actually, I sprayed it over here too on the back door. And you guys can just see that little stripe right there. That's a really good match. So I think we're gonna roll with that. And above that, you can see I sprayed the other blue and it's just too dark. So you could see the two little testings I did on the back door there. And then we'll sand all that off a little bit and then spray paint the whole thing. But I don't know if we're gonna get to the spray paint in this video for the blue. I definitely wanna rebuild the control panel and address all the metal parts. But yeah, why don't we just kinda get to work here? So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the game off. And let's yank this control panel off. And I just need to go underneath here and unlatch it. There's one on this side and one on that side right there. And we're just gonna pull the control panel off. And rebuilding control panels, I think, is one of the most important parts of a restore because this is how you interface with the game. And if the control panel sucks and the buttons don't work and the joystick's crappy and it just looks bad, to me, that's like your first impression of a game. And the control panel, you gotta take the time to rebuild it. You just have to, you know? Because like I said, it's how you interface with the game. And if the controls are not good and dialed in, the gameplay is just not fun. So let me come in here. There's a Molex connector that is connected to this right down here. So we're just gonna disconnect this. Okay, and then let's bring the control panel over to the table here. Oh, by the way, check this out. So I picked this up because I'm like skateboarding crazy right now. I don't know what's going on with me. I'm clearly having some kind of midlife crisis, but I've been skateboarding a lot. I've been going to the skate park. I'm totally into it. And so I've been kind of thinking I want to maybe start collecting some of the older skateboards. And I've been looking around and they're super expensive, guys. I mean, the old original 80s skateboards are big money, right? And I saw this on Craigslist, and the guy wanted like $500 for it, and I talked him down quite a bit, actually. This is an original, okay, not a reissue. This is an original 1983 Tony Hawk board, okay? And it's in amazing shape, absolutely amazing shape. It's all original. It's got the Bones rails, the Bones tail guard. It had the Bones nose, which I actually took off, the nose bone. I took it off because the white PVC plastic turned like yellow, and right now it's inside soaking in bleach, so I'm gonna put it back on. I'm hoping it kind of turns back to white. But anyway, this is all original, guys, and I mean, this is just amazing because when this board came out, you gotta understand something. Tony Hawk was 15 years old, okay? He had been a pro for a year when this board came out. This is the first board to have this graphic right here, okay? And they would use this graphic for many years, but this is the board that had that graphic first. And this is called the pig board, okay? It's a 10 by 30 board, and it's just a big fat pig. I mean, it's gigantic. And believe it or not, they did not sell a lot of these boards. This is actually a very rare skateboard because, again, Tony Hawk was 15 years old. He wasn't a household name when this board came out, okay? So they didn't sell a ton of them. And this is a full year before they did those videos because, you know, Stacy Peralta did like these Tony Hawk, they did Bones Brigade videos on VHS in 84 that really exposed the whole world to this crew. You know, the Bones Brigade was like Rodney Mullen and Caballero and Guerrero and Tony Hawk and Mike McGill and Lance Mountain, etc. And so when that video came out, these guys were kind of instant celebrities, but this board came out before that and nobody knew who the heck Tony Hawk was. And he just wasn't really the pro that we know now. So this is actually a very rare board. They didn't sell a lot of them at all. And this is the early Paul Peralta Dragon graphic. They would later refine this a little bit. Like the tail here is like a fat tail with these little barbs. In later boards, it would be really skinny and pointy and they would lose all these barbs, and it would add a copyright notice down here. So this is the very first early version of this Dragon 83. I mean, come on, this thing is sick. And maybe later in the video, we'll replace the bearings. Do you guys wanna do that? I know this is not a skateboard video, But I picked up some bearings. I thought it'd be kind of fun maybe if we replaced the bearings later, because this thing needs new bearings. Now, I'm not really going to ride this skateboard. I have another skateboard that I ride. It's a Birdhouse Kevin Staub model. It's like an 8.5-inch deck. That's the one I'd ride at the skate park. So I'm not going to ride this. This is really like wall art, and it's just too rare and historic to take to the skate park and damage, because it's got some scratches here. This is actually considered really not that bad because the graphics are all intact, and I just don't want to add any more scratches to it because it's such an important piece. It's got the original Paul Peralta Bones 3s wheels, okay, which are cool. These are the big fat wheels we were riding in the 80s. It has the original independent trucks, okay? These are OG, you know, 80s model independent trucks. It's got the original snap bushings in here. So yeah, this thing's cool. All right, I'll shut up about skateboards. So let's move on. We're gonna rebuild this control panel. We might come back to the Tony Hawk board because I do want to replace those bearings. I thought it'd be kind of fun to do that because there's actually a little bit of a trick to replace bearings. So anyway, okay, so here's our control panel. And it's pretty ugly, okay? This is the original overlay, which is actually really great, okay? Because I'll show you here. They actually had a couple flavor overlays for these games. And Rich from This Old Game actually sent me a reproduction Jump Bug, actually Rockola overlay, okay? So here's Rich's reproduction. We're not gonna use this, okay? Because I don't want to. Because the original Jump Bug overlay had this little instruction card thing kind of built into the overlay. So we're not gonna touch this. This is impossible to replace, okay? We've got some cigarette burns here. It's, you know what, that's okay. We'll live with the cigarette burns. We're gonna clean this up really nice. We'll take some magic eraser and make the white really pop. But I don't wanna use this reproduction because it's just too generic. And there's no instruction sticker here, so we'll keep the original. But Rich, thank you for sending me this. And then we also have some reproduction side art that we'll be using later. So I'm gonna put this stuff to the side, and we'll come back to that probably in the following video when we do the sides. But anyway, so why don't we get to work here? We gotta really just take this control panel apart. There's some very unoriginal screws on here, so I'm gonna have to see what I can do about that. Maybe go to the hardware store, because originally I'm guessing it had security screws like this, these squares, okay? And someone replaced these. That just does not look right. So I'm gonna go to the hardware store later and see if we can find some screws that look a little more OG, you know? But why don't we come in here and just start unscrewing stuff. And just gotta take this whole thing apart, clean it, paint it. Okay, so we do have these security bits here. Let me get my security bit set and see if we have that square. I'm sure I do. And this is a set of security bits. I buy these usually on eBay. I've got like 5 sets of these. There is no square in there, and no square in that one. Let me see if I've got some more bits back here. Huh, I don't. Okay, so I'm looking here at my other set. Crap, I don't have any squares. Well, that sucks. How are we gonna get those screws off? Let me look around here. I'm looking in my tool chest. Damn it. No squares. Ah, what's this? Is that a square? That's a hex. I wonder if I can kind of make one of these work. Let's try one of these hex ones. Maybe we can just kind of use one of these and... I don't think I've ever encountered the square screws. All right, you know what I'm gonna do here? I'm gonna look around. I might have to go to the hardware store and see if they have any square bits. I'll be back. All right, I figured it out. I'm using this little flathead, okay? And I'm able to get it on the screw here and just kind of wedge it in the square, and the screw comes right off. So we'll use that. I'm just using a little flathead standard bit, and I'm able to just kind of wedge it in that square. Actually works perfect. Okay, so we got these screws here. Let me take this one off. Okay, so we got the metal parts off. Here's all of our screws. I think I'm gonna tumble these. We'll put these in our little tumbler. I'm gonna get all my screws together and we'll put all these in the tumbler and let it tumble overnight, and which will be good. So, all right, so we got all the screws off. So let's turn this guy over and we just gotta start removing all this crap. We got this stuff here and here and here. The buttons are, let me get my channel locks. And my socket set here. So the buttons, these are original leaf switches. So we gotta definitely wanna keep those. So we're just gonna loosen the pell nuts. Okay, let's pop this thing off here. So let's come in here and just pop all these off. Let me just break all these. Okay. Now, do we want to label these so that it's easy to put back together? I don't know. Let me think about this. So this is player one. This is player two. We could take a marker and just kind of... We'll just come in here and say 2, 2, 1, 1. And then I'll just do horizontal. I'll just put a plus here. That way it'll just be a little easier to put back together. All right, so let's get all this apart. And really, I mean, if you're gonna rebuild your control panel, you just have to take the whole thing apart. Just take it all apart, and then you're just gonna kind of scrutinize every little part of it. So let's pull all these buttons out. Okay, so that's all free. Okay, let me get my nut drivers. We'll pull the joystick off. So I'm gonna grab some needle nose pliers. And we're gonna yank the joystick off, and I'll show you guys how to do that. So with the joystick, there's a little C-clip down here. We gotta pop that off. And just be careful when you do this because these clips tend to fly across the room. And I'm just gonna come in here. There, okay. So the C-clip's right here, okay. And then the joystick should just come out just like so. All right, and then take that little part there. And we're gonna clean this all up, make that look really pretty. So let me take my nut drivers and we're gonna just remove these nuts here. Okay. That's too big. What size is that? That's 3/8. Don't seem to have the right size nut driver. Okay, so that works. 11/32. All right. And I'm just removing these four nuts. This is an original Wico style joystick, and I love these joysticks. They feel so good. They're nice leaf switch joysticks, and definitely want to keep the original one. Don't attempt to replace this with a modern, micro switch joystick. You want to keep these original joysticks because they just have such a wonderful feel. All right, so let's pop these nuts out here. Okay, and there's some kind of metal plate here. Clean that up, and you can see, man, look at this thing. It's just gunked up. So we're gonna clean the heck out of this. Oh man, it's nasty. All right, so what's holding all this on? We've got this. OK. Okay, and then why don't we take these off while we're at it? And we'll throw all this stuff in our tumbler. Okay, so we got everything off of this. So now we just need to clean this up really well. And I'm gonna put this to the side. Let's put our metal parts to the side. Let's put this over here. Let's take this mess and put it to the side. All right, so I've got all these screws. And this little E-clip. So I wanna tumble this stuff. So let me get my tumbler and I'll show you what we're gonna do. Okay, so here's my tumbler. I bought this on Amazon. This thing was really cheap. It's the Quick and Easy Case Tumbler. I don't remember what it was. Something like 40 bucks or it wasn't too expensive. And the media that we're gonna use is this stuff here, which is Desert Blend Ground English Walnut Shells. Okay, so we're gonna use that. So let me open this guy up. We're gonna fill this up. Okay. Is there like a fill line on here? I'm not sure how far we're supposed to fill this. That's probably good. Okay, so yeah, we're about half. 2/3, 5/8 full. And then I'm just gonna take all my rusty parts here and we're just gonna drop them in this tumbler. Okay, so we got all these little carriage bolts, these security screws. And we'll throw the pal nuts in there from the buttons. And we'll just let this thing clean all these parts for us while we're working. And then we're not gonna throw the joystick in there. We're not gonna throw the plastic buttons. We could throw the C-clips in there that are on the buttons. Should we do that? Yeah, why not? So I wanna take apart these buttons because I wanna clean them anyway. So I'm gonna come in here with my pliers and just pull the C-clip off like so, okay? And then when you do that, the button just kind of falls apart and then you get the spring part right there. So I'm gonna throw the spring in there and the C-clip. And we're gonna take all these buttons apart and do the same thing. So let's just drop the clip in there and the rusty spring. See that? And we'll throw that in there. Okay. Rusty spring. So this one. Huh, this button is missing the C-clip altogether and the spring. Huh, so this button's hosed. It's interesting. Okay. And I'm gonna try to reuse these old buttons just because, wow, this one's missing the C-clip and the spring too. Weird. We might end up replacing the buttons, we'll see. If this doesn't turn out well, I think I'll replace them. These are just white buttons. Long for the wood control panel. So Bob Roberts sells these. If I can find some nice, decent buttons, I'll probably order new ones. But for now, let's try cleaning the parts. Let's keep all the plastics right there. All right, so I'm gonna plug this in and we're just gonna let this thing go here. And let's turn it on. Isn't that awesome? So let's go ahead and put the lid on. I might go put this downstairs because it's gonna be kind of loud up here while we're doing the video. Ah, vibrating too much. All right. Let's see if we can tolerate that noise. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and clean this up because this is a big mess right now, and I'll be right back. Okay, actually, one thing I wanna do here while we're getting ready to do all the metal parts is I need to take off this bottom rail that's holding the marquee on because I wanna tumble those screws, and we're also gonna paint this bracket. So this also has those square security bits, and I'm just using that standard bit here, which actually works pretty awesome to get these out. Okay. All right, so we got that off. And I'm gonna throw these three screws in our tumbler too. I'm wondering if I should take the coin door off now, because it would be kind of nice to tumble all these. This coin door is actually a piece of crap. I need to find the parts that I'm missing. Because you can see here, this little bezel thing is cracked, and this is missing the flap, okay? And so I'm wondering if we should take this coin door off now and I could start tumbling all these parts. I think I should do that. So let me get my socket set. Let's see what's, there's two Molex connectors here. One, two, okay. If you guys can see that, there's two Molex connectors holding that on. And then there's a ground strap right here that's gonna come off when we remove these bolts. So let me get my, my socket set, and we'll go to town on this. So there's just four nuts in there. Let's see, where's my socket set? Here it is. Okay. So let's figure out which size we need here. Looks like that guy right there. And we're just gonna come in here and break this stuff. And we're gonna throw all this stuff in the tumbler. So while we're working, the tumbler is kind of doing its thing for us. And wow, there's one, two, there's one. The bolts were missing on this side over here. So we're gonna have to figure out a way to hold this out here. Is there a dead mouse in here? What the hell is that? Okay, there's some really weird grossness in there. Is that a dead mouse? Let's take a look here. What is going on? There's something really strange in here. You guys can see that. What is that? No, it's just some bedding. It looked like a little animal. That was weird. We're gonna have to vacuum and clean this thing a little bit more. Gross. All right. So anyway, we got all the nuts and bolts from the coin door off. I pulled the coin door off. It's over here. So we're gonna throw all these parts in the tumbler. And let's take a look at the coin door and figure out what we're gonna do with it. Cause we're definitely gonna wanna paint it. And it's got this little board right here, which is unique to these Rockola games. This is some kind of a credit board where you can configure each coin counter to do certain stuff. I'm not really sure, to be honest, but this thing uses like AC power. And it's not really sitting on the bracket right. Actually, when I was playing with the game before, like if I were to move this thing in the wrong spot, it would actually ground. It would short out to the plate here. So we gotta definitely mount this thing back on here better. But I think we should go ahead and just take this whole thing apart. Let's get rid of this old crappy lock that we're not gonna use. Because I don't have the key to this lock, so we're just gonna have to just throw this thing out. And we'll replace it with one of my normal locks. So let's take this lock off. Okay. So let's just throw this in the garbage. We don't need that. All right, so what's going on here? We got screws here, nuts there. So why don't we pop all of those off, and then the whole like assembly should just basically fall off. So let me get my nut drivers, and hopefully I got the right size here. Too big. Ah, screw it. I'll just use my socket set. I seem to have lost a bunch of my nut drivers. Okay, so we're just going to basically take off these six nuts. One, two, three. Actually, is it just three? It's one, two. Let me see. Because this whole assembly is just going to come right off. One. I never noticed that there's a pot right here. Is there a volume pot right there? I was adjusting the volume on the PCB. I think I just take these two nuts off and this whole thing's gonna pop off. Looks like you need to take this one off too. Yep. Okay, so there you go. That's that. Okay, so the whole assembly just comes off, and we'll kind of address that later. So let's go ahead and just pull all of this stuff off here. This stuff's all filthy. Here's the little door. Actually, there's two screws here. Let's undo those. Let me get the right size screwdriver. One. Okay. Screws there. Okay, so these are the little bezel things with the little door, and you can see this one's destroyed. So I'm gonna have to try to find these somewhere. Maybe just even order a new coin door, I don't know. Let's take these chutes off right here. So we're probably going to want to hammer this because see how it's all bent here? And I'll probably take my mallet and see if we can straighten that out. Okay, so that's all off. Okay. Just put this stuff to the side. So what I want to do now is take this hinge off, okay? Because this front part is, there's a hinge, and there's just four screws holding it on. So I'm going to go ahead and just take these four screws off. Got all four screws off, so now we've got our two parts right here. So let me just put these to the side for now. And there's some actually extra holes drilled into this. Wonderful. We'll have to address that. Okay. So I've got all these screws and stuff that I just took off the coin door. I'm gonna throw these in our tumbler. This little metal door, I think we'll leave that out. This is all plastic stuff, so we're not gonna tumble that. And then we've got these parts here and these springs. So let's put these springs in the tumbler. These are plastic though, we're not gonna, this is actually missing. Boy, this coin door is a piece of crap. This is missing in the little cover here. So I'm gonna have to try to find all these parts. And here's the little 25 cent insert that's totally hosed. So we can reprint that on our printer. Actually, I'm gonna take all these plastic parts. This and this, and then we got all our buttons too. I'm gonna have to get another cup. I wanna soak all this stuff just to clean it up. And I'm gonna use, I guess we'll use a little bit of this. This is just all-purpose cleaner with bleach, just generic crap. Just gonna throw that in there. And then also put some Simple Green in there and make a little cocktail. And I usually do this all the time for buttons and plastic stuff. Just kind of let it soak overnight. And it tends to just kind of break up all the gunk and stuff. Where is my Simple Green? I just bought like a gallon of it. Arrgh. Where is it? Just throw some of this in here. So we'll just let that stuff soak. I'm gonna kind of put it out of the way so we don't dump it over. Let me get another cup too, because we're gonna soak our buttons. All right, I got another cup here. So I'm gonna just drop all these button parts in here and the plastics and the little joystick spacer. Just put those all in a cup and then we'll just pour some Simple Green in here. This is actually Mean Green, which is like the dollar store brand. I find it to be just as good. Throw a little bit of this in there too. All right, so we're gonna let that stuff all soak. I'm gonna put this to the side just so we don't knock it over. Okay, so what are we gonna do now? Well, I'm gonna throw those screws and all that stuff in the tumbler, and then I think we're gonna start attacking the control panel. So let me clean this up again and I'll be back. Okay, I put all the parts in there, and I'm gonna use some of this Novus 3. I went downstairs and grabbed this, and we're just gonna kind of squirt this on our media, just to kind of give it a little bit of like a polishing agent. You can use like Novus 3. I've used wax before, like liquid wax for cars and stuff, but I had some of this. I thought we'd just throw some of this in here. Kind of helps polish the stuff. Have a lot though. It's probably plenty. All right, anyway, I'm gonna close this up and I'll let it turn it back on and I'll be right back. Okay, so what do you wanna do next? I think I'm gonna clean this control panel. This thing's filthy. I'm just gonna take some of this Mean Green. This is, you can get this at Dollar General. I use it all the time. And we're just gonna spray the heck out of this thing. Just get all of this gunk off of this thing. Back's not too bad. We gotta be careful, this is like particle board, but, or MDF. But I don't want it to be filthy here. Let's get all the big loose stuff off first. And then I'm gonna come in with like a magic eraser and we'll really get all these stains off of here. I actually like this art. You know, the Rockola cabinets are fairly generic, really, but the art that is there is pretty cute. You know, like, I like that. The colors are happy. Bright blue and red.
I don't believe we don't belong. No one can see what we've got. I don't believe we don't belong. No one can see what we've got.
Okay, I cleaned this thing all up with Simple Green, got all the chunky stuff off. And overall, it looks okay. It's not perfect though. We still need to clean it some more. You can see some discoloration right here. See how this is the original color that was underneath the metal. Then you can see how it kind of turns to this dark blue right here, and then the light blue. And over here, the whites are just not very white. They just look dirty and dingy. So we're gonna use a magic eraser to clean this up, to clean the rest of it up here. And I'm just using this Mr. Clean Magic Eraser. This is the extra power one. I don't know. It's more powerful. It's like $3 for two of them. So let's come in here. I already moistened this. I ran it over the sink in the sink under the faucet, and it's a little wet. And so I'm just gonna come in here, and we're just gonna kinda... This is like a very high grit sandpaper, basically. And you can see already that the whites are turning white. God. Stuff just is amazing. And the cigarette burns, we're just gonna live with those. It's all right, it's got some 80s character. And I'm gonna keep it moist with a little Simple Green. I mean, you could tell already that the white is popping here. This shit really works. And I use these magic erasers all the time with control panel overlays. They just, it's magical. Hence the name. So let's really try to make our whites pop in here. All right, let's wipe this down and see what we got. Actually really good. So you could see that discoloration we had going from the blue underneath the metal to the area that was not is gone. Our whites are really popping here. So look at that. That just looks fantastic. I'm actually gonna go over it one more time. Why not? And see if we can make it pop even more. And again, we're not replacing this control panel overlay just because I can't. There's no reproduction, and it's really not in that bad a shape for original. It's got some character. And these things like kind of start disintegrating as you use them. Which is normal. All right, I think that's pretty good. I'm just gonna come in here and just kind of rinse it off. So how does that look? I think it looks pretty damn good. I mean, all that discoloration is gone. The whites are white. They're not dirty. So that was a success. Done. How's it look, guys? Look how even the blues are. So good. And that area is popping right there. It doesn't look dingy, so. Okay, so we're done with that. Let's just put this to the side here. So let me clean up, and I think we're gonna move on to the joystick. Let's rebuild that guy. Okay, so let's take this joystick apart. All the wires here on the switches are soldered, so we're probably just gonna leave that alone, but there's four screws right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I want to undo all of those, and then the whole thing should just basically come apart, and we can get to the grommet, which is what we want to replace. So let's unscrew the top here from the base. And the top piece here, I really want to clean because it's filthy. Okay, so that should come off. And it's a little filthy, we'll clean that up. But here's the part we're interested in. And so here's the original grommet. And I want to kind of pay attention how this goes here because the washer goes on top of the grommet and then the plastic washer goes on top of the grommet in between that. So it goes metal, grommet, plastic. Okay, so here's the original grommet. And look at that. That thing's just blown out. See that? So we definitely want to replace that because this thing is doing nothing. Wow. And luckily, I have a replacement. There was a guy on Clove. He had a website for a short while. I don't even know if he still has these for sale. But it was like gamegrommets.com, and he did an initial run, and I grabbed a bunch of them, knowing that I would absolutely need them later. So I've got some here, and I want to see like how this goes on, because there's, I think I took it off like this, because there's like, if you look at it, there's this end here sticks out more than that end, and I believe that the end that sticks out more we want towards the bottom. So like that. You can see the new grommet here. Not shredded. Boy, that thing was really blown out. That was doing nothing. And that's why that joystick felt so loose. So let's clean up this base, the top part here, because this thing is just filthy. I'm just gonna wipe it down and just get all this gunk off of here. And after we rebuild this here with a new grommet, this is gonna be like a brand new joystick. And then this part here, I wanna just kinda carefully clean this up. Spray a little bit on here. Pretty good. Okay, so let's put this back together. And so, let me clean up this little plastic washer thing. Like so. Should clean up the metal one too. I suppose we could toss this in our tumbler, but I just want to get this over with real quick. All right, so let's get this crap out of here. All right, so let's put it back together. So the plastic washer goes on first, and then we're going to take our new grommet. And I'm trying to think here. Yeah, the tall side was towards the back, like so. Okay, and then we had a metal one on top. Maybe the I'm actually trying to figure out what makes the most sense. Would the tall side be up or the short side? I wonder if I should go look at a picture of this, because I wasn't paying attention when I took it off. I'm not sure if the tall side should go towards the top of the joystick or on towards the bottom of the joystick. I'm guessing it will feel the same. Yeah, maybe I'll go look at an exploded view of a Wico joystick. Alright, I just googled this, and the tall side of the grommet goes towards the ball top. So, I just want to make sure I pick the best grommet here. I think they're all the same. Pretty sure these are all the repros. Alright, let's use this one. So, the tall side is going to go towards the ball top, so let's put that in here like so. And then our metal washer goes on like so. And then this goes over the whole thing. And then just trying to line up our screws. So pretty basic. Just put it back together. And then this is gonna go through like this. Just wanna test it out. You gotta get that washer to line up. The metal washer. There we go. Feels actually really good. Okay, so what I want to do now, so this is all rebuilt, we're ready to put it back together, but I need to address the joystick shaft itself because it's all rusty. We're just going to take some sandpaper and just get all that surface rust off of there. So I'm going to come over here and grab some sandpaper, and why don't we use, this is 60 grit. Why don't we start with 60? And I'm just gonna come in here. Now when you do this, you gotta be careful that you don't come up too high and you start scratching the ball. It's really easy to do. And I usually just go just like that. And we just wanna get all that rust off of it. And it usually comes off pretty easily. See, that looks pretty darn good. So I'd say we got all the rust off. Maybe I'll come in here with some, what is this, 600? Just kind of polish it up. Okay, that looks actually great. So there we go. Our joystick ball and shaft is all ready to go back together. Okay, so the control panel really is all set. The joystick's rebuilt, it's all clean. So really, we need to move on to these metal parts. This is that plate that was on the top. I think I'm gonna paint this. It's got some rust on it. I think we'll use that blue paint that we're gonna use for the rest of the cabinet and just paint this up. So why don't we get ready here to paint? So we need to paint all of these metal parts, okay? I definitely need to get all of the surface rust off. Now this coin door has some holes in it, which is a real bummer. some right there, and there's some right here. Looks like an operator might have put like some kind of lock bar on here or something. So we're gonna need something to fill this up with. I wanna get like some JB Weld or something and maybe some washers. I think what we'll do is we'll JB Weld some washers to the back here and then fill it in with JB Weld and then sand it smooth. I've done this before, like on the Gyrus coin door, it had some drilled holes, but I don't have any JB Weld, so I need to go to the, actually, you guys wanna come? Let's go to the hardware store and let's get some washers and some JB Weld and see if we can find some stuff to patch up these holes. All right, guys, let's go. All right, so we need to get some washers. I'm gonna get like a little package of $1.29. Those should be, maybe there's something with a smaller hole. Those should work. And then I want to get some kind of a wood filler or a metal filler, like a JB Bond, JB Weld. And they've got this stuff here, liquid metal filler. I think this is what I used before on the Journey. I think it was a Journey, was it Gyrus? I don't remember, but this is like JB Weld. It says that we can apply saw for filling, bonding, repairing, can be drilled, filed, sanded, and painted, gasoline and oil resistant. All right, guys, we got it. So let's go back. Okay, and we're back. So we got the liquid metal filler and the flat washers. I do think though, before we fill these in, I wanna sand this and also I wanna straighten this out. This is all bent here. And if you look here, it looks like someone kicked in this door. It's kind of pushed in. So we're gonna just kind of pound it flat the best we can. I'm just gonna come in here. I'm gonna lay this on the ground like so. And then I'm just gonna come in with a rubber mallet. And let's just see if we flatten this thing out. It's a little straighter. There we go, it just popped. Okay. It's kind of like oil canning. I think that's a little bit better. And then over here, I really need to address this. And I'm just gonna take a standard hammer and see if we can straighten this out. Definitely better than it was. It's not perfect. That's actually looking pretty good. So what do you think? That looks better. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. There's a little bit of a dimple right here.
Let's see if we can get that out.
Yeah, that looks really good. So nice and straight there. So let's come over here and we're gonna sand this guy down. So I wanna get all this rust off. You can see in here, it's all rusted. It's actually kind of loose. We'll probably have to sand this by hand because I'm not gonna be able to get in here with my palm sander. And then I just wanna get all of this surface rust off of here before we paint it. And same thing with these guys right here. So I'm gonna come in with my palm sander. I have 60 grit sandpaper on here. And we're just gonna go to town on all this stuff, get all the surface rust off, and get it all ready for painting. And then we'll also plug up these holes before we paint. But I wanna sand it first. So let's go ahead and sand this stuff. Program to be young. Okay, guys, I think we're done here. That was actually a ton of work. It took forever, and I bought this general purpose 60 grit sandpaper. It's kind of junky. It was really falling apart on me. I don't really advise buying this. Spend a little more and get the better stuff. This is all they had at the store, though, I went to today. So it's just a 60 grit general purpose. Not good, to be honest. I like this purple stuff that 3M sells, but I didn't have any of the 60 grit of this. This stuff's pretty good, the pro grade. I don't recommend using that basic stuff. It was literally falling apart within seconds after I started sanding. So anyway, I went through here. I got all the surface rust off all these pieces, okay? So I'd say these are all pretty much ready for painting. They're all nice and smooth. Now the coin door was actually not that easy to do. I've got most of the rust off here. I think we'll be just fine. Because my plan is this. We're gonna hit this with a hammered finish first, okay? And this stuff's great because it really hides any of the imperfections and low points that we might have here. And originally this coin door had a hammer finish and I just removed all of it, okay? So the plan is this, we're gonna hit it with the hammer finish first, let it dry, we'll get our texture that we want, and then we'll go over it with a satin, because the hammered finish color is kind of a weird off black, it's almost gray, and it's kind of glossy. I don't like it by itself, so usually I'll hit it with this first, and then go over it with the satin, and that's kind of the plan here. But first, we need to plug up these holes, okay? We've got two holes right here, and I've got two holes right here. And we're gonna use that patch stuff that we got at the hardware store, and we're gonna use some washers, okay? So this is the liquid metal filler. And so the plan is this, we're gonna stick washers to the back first, okay? And then we'll come up in the front and add some of more of that filler. But the washers are gonna kinda help give us a backing, okay? And I'm gonna kinda put them on there, not quite centered. I wonder if I have any bigger washers I should use. Because I don't want the stuff to ooze to the back, you know? And let me see if I have any other washers. If not, we'll use those. Those will probably be okay, but I kind of want some washers with some more meat on them so I can really fill up that hole. So the washer is really covering up that hole real nice. Let's see how these look. These are much bigger, but they might be okay. Let's see, this one we could put here, and that'll cover that hole nicely. And then this one we can kind of sneak in here, or maybe if we do that, that's not too bad. We can do that and that. What do you think of that? I wonder if I can cut these down. Eh, whatever. You know, it doesn't bother me that there's washers in the back. You're never gonna see it, and it's better than seeing the holes in the front. Put one there and one there. Let's try that. Let me see how much this one covers. It covers most of it. Maybe we'll use these small ones. It's a little less sightly, unsightly. Yeah, we'll use the small ones. Like that and that. All right, so let's get some of this filler bonder stuff. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kinda, I gotta break the seal here. Get a small screwdriver. So let's break this open. Let me wipe my screwdriver down. Okay, so we're gonna come in here with some of this stuff, and I'm just gonna put it around the hole. And then I'm just gonna come in with my washer and just kinda stick it. Right there. Okay. This is exactly what we did when we did the that gyrus coin door. And this stuff really hardens. Okay. All right, so we'll just leave that like that. Okay, and then let's go do the other one. and we're gonna let that dry. It's gonna take a good hour here. And then we'll come in the front. And it's kind of oozing out the front, which is okay. Actually, we'll just kind of go like this, see how that works. We might have to let this dry and then build it up a little bit more. Okay, I'm just gonna leave that like so. And just let it sit. And then we're gonna paint over this. And we'll sand it down a little bit so it's not so ugly. Okay. So there's that. And I'm just gonna let it ooze out the front. That's okay. And we're gonna sand this smooth. Okay, so that's that. Let's let that dry. And then over here, we need to do the same thing. So we're gonna patch these two holes. Let me go ahead and just put some of this stuff here. And I sanded as much as I could around it. So let's put that there. So are these washers gonna interfere? Because this part here goes flush against the game. I'm a little worried that the washers are gonna cause problems. So I wonder if we can get away with not using washers. Never tried that before. Yeah, why don't we try filling this in and then we'll sand this down. I'm gonna try it without washers on this side. Because I don't want this sticking out from the game. So I'm just gonna fill this in. And let it harden. And then we'll come in from the front and fill it in. And then I'll sand this smooth after it dries. So let's just do it like that. And it's kind of oozing out the front here. It's kind of ugly. All right, we're gonna let that dry. And then while this is drying, why don't we start painting the metal parts with the satin? And how long does this take to dry? 3 to 4 hours. Okay. So we'll come back later tonight. Okay. So let's why don't we hit these metal parts with a coat of paint? Let me get some cardboard set up on the ground. Okay, actually, before I paint these, I'm going to clean these up, though, because, you know, there's all kinds of sanding dust and gunk on here, so I'm just going to spray them all with Simple Green and wipe them down, because I don't want to paint dirt. So let's get these things nice and clean before we paint them. You can see all the stuff that's coming off here. And I want these to, like, really fully dry before we paint them, too. Okay, so I'll go ahead and clean the rest of these and then we'll hit them with paint. Okay, these are all ready to be painted. They're all dry and clean. I'm gonna use Rust-Oleum Universal Satin Paint and Primer in one. I love this paint. And I'm gonna paint the backside first. I always do that just because when I flip them over, if it sticks for some reason, I want it to stick on the back to the cardboard. So let's go ahead here and just hit these guys. I need to take the little safety thing off here. And we'll just do one coat here. And I'll let it dry and come in with a second coat. Now this is paint and primer in one, so there's really no need to apply primer right now. I really get good results with this paint. All right, so we'll let that dry, and then I'll come back and put another coat on. And then I also want to address that plate, okay? Because there was that metal plate on top of the control panel right here, and it was blue, and I sanded all the rust off of it, so I want to paint this blue. However, I'm gonna put some primer on it first, because the paint I'm using is not, oh no, it is actually, it is paint and primer in one. I take that back. I thought for some reason it wasn't. So we're gonna use this gloss brilliant blue, and I'm not gonna prime this, and I'm just kind of looking here. There's a little bit of a bump on this thing. I wonder if I should hammer that down real quick. It's not perfectly flat. Let's see if we can make it so. Now it is. All right. Good. Okay, so let's hit that with that blue, that brilliant blue, which is a pretty pleasant color. And hopefully it matches pretty well. So it's Saturday, it is a gorgeous day, and I feel like I'm really in full garage mode now. You know, like the last few weeks, the last few videos I've done, I've been putting them off till Sunday. And today, this weekend, nope, I'm out here on Saturday, which is what I was doing last year at the Journey. I was filming on Saturday and then releasing on Sunday. God, that color is, I think, dead nuts on. All right, so let's let that dry. And okay, so we're gonna let this dry, let that dry. We've got the coin door drying with our little patch job here. And let's let everything dry. I'm gonna clean up in here and then we'll come back. All right, while everything's drying here, do you guys wanna change some skate bearings? Does this sound fun? I think so. All right, so we're gonna change the bearings on this skateboard. Again, this is a 1983 OG original Tony Hawk board. And you can see the bearings are just kind of really not working very well at all. The wheel just barely spins. So we're going to replace the bearings, and we're going to use the Bones Super Reds. These are kind of the middle of the road bearings. They have regular old Reds, which are, you know, these are made in China, and they have Bones Super Reds, which I guess are a little bit better. And then there's like the Swiss bearings, which are the best ones, but they're just a lot of money. So we'll put the Super Reds on here. You know, I don't really plan on riding this skateboard, but I'd like to get the old bearings off of here because we can. And I did ride it once. I took this over to Adam's house. He's got a mini ramp in his backyard. And it was weird riding this board, man. It's so big. It's so gigantic. So it's just crazy. So here's our new bearings. Okay, and it comes with a little Super Red sticker. Okay, so we need to get the wheels off. And so I'm gonna use a skate tool. You can use anything you want. You could use a socket set, but we're gonna use the skate tool to get the wheels off. And we're gonna come in here and just loosen up the nut. Now there's usually a washer, which they call the speed ring, behind the nut. So you gotta be careful here that you don't lose that. Okay, so let's kind of pull this off. And I'm gonna kind of dump this out here. There's our little nut, our little speed ring right there. And where did the nut go? Oh, it must be in here, okay. So there's our little washer. That's like the speed ring, okay? And there's also one on the inside right here, okay? Right there. So we'll kind of just clean that up a little bit. Okay, so how do we do this? So we need to get the old bearings out of this. So let me get a little screwdriver and we'll pop them out. So let's pop out the bearing, okay? And inside here is a spacer, okay, which we wanna keep. That's the spacer right there, and I'll show you guys how that works. And let's take the other bearing off here on this side. This side might be a little tricky. Maybe we can just, let's do that. Okay, so here's our old bearings. They barely spin, okay? So let's put that over here. Let's take our nut and our washer and keep that here. Okay, so here's our new bearings. Okay, now you're gonna notice there's two sides on these bearings, okay? On the Super Reds, there's a black side. On the regular Reds, this side is actually red. Okay, Super Reds is black. And on the other side is kind of like a clear, like washer type thing that's over the bearings themselves. The idea here is you pop off this and you can clean the bearings, okay? But we want the black side, the solid side that's covering the bearings, to be on the outside of the wheels, okay? And so what we're gonna do is, so we got our washer on here first. Let me kind of get close up and we'll show you guys this. Okay, so we have our washer right here. So that goes on first, okay? Then we're gonna take this bearing and put the black side towards the axle, okay? Just like so. Then we're gonna take our speed ring, our spacer, which is right here, okay? And then we're gonna put our spacer on, okay? And then we're gonna take our next bearing, and again, the black side's gonna go towards the axle, okay? Just like so, okay? Then we take our wheels, and now we're gonna take the outside, which is the logo side, and we're gonna put that on first, okay? We're gonna come in here and we're gonna basically pick up this bearing, and because we put it with the black side in, okay, it's gonna actually go in that way, and then when we pull it out, you'll see. So let's go ahead and put this on here. It's gotta push, okay, and then we're gonna pull out. So now the bearing's in there with the black side out, and then we come in here, and now we're gonna keep our spacer there, and then the inside bearing right there, and just push. And that's it. Our new bearings on. And then our new bearings are on. And then we take our washer and put it over the axle. And then we take our nut and put that back on. And that's it. Now with the spacer, if you don't have a spacer, you can't really tighten this down all the way. If you have a spacer, you can, because the spacer is in between the bearings, kind of preventing them from going any further towards each other. If you have no spacer, you can kind of over tighten it because the outside bearing has give because there's no spacer in there. Does that make sense? So we can kind of tighten this all the way. Usually what I do is I tighten it till it's snug and then I just back off just a little bit. So I'm tightening. There, right there's snug. I'm just gonna go a little bit, that's snug, and I'm gonna back off just a hair. And that's too much. Snug, and let me just back off just a notch. Right there. And there we go. Nice spinning wheel. So let's go ahead and do the next one together. And you don't want the wheel to move left or right at all, okay? And that's what the spacer does, is that you can tighten it all the way down, and the spacer's in between the bearings, making sure they don't compress on each other. And then you get no left and right travel with the wheel. So let's go ahead and do one more together. So we did this one. So let's do this guy right here. Pretty simple, right? I remember when I was a kid, this was like a mystery. Like, how do you change bearings? Like, you know, you go to the skate shop and you have the guy do it behind the counter, and it was just kind of magical. He was like a skate wizard, but really, changing bearings is simple. It's kind of fun too. Oh, okay, there's our washer, all right. Our nut is in our tool, so let's put that stuff there. All right, so let's pop the old bearings out. Where's our inner washer? Okay, it's there. So let's pop this out. Here's our old one. Here's our spacer, okay? And let's kind of come in here, kick that one out. Okay, so there's our old bearings. These things are just totally gummed up. I mean, I suppose we can clean them, but whatever. Bearings are cheap. They're like 20 bucks on Amazon. So, all right, so we have our washer on first, okay? So I'm gonna put the black side towards the axle, and then the spacer, and then we're gonna take a new bearing here, put the black side towards the axle, okay? So I'm gonna come in here with the logo side towards the axle first, push it, and we grab that bearing. And I'm gonna come in here and put the logo side out, and that's it. And then we'll put our washer on. And then our nut. Get it started by my hand, and then come in with our skate tool. Snug, and I'm just gonna back off of here. There you go. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the next two.
Guns and germs, what you are, you can't give me rise of love. Got your jury, got your germs, you can make me rise of love.
Okay, I got all new bearings and all four wheels, and another thing I want to do is, this thing is really loose. It's like seriously loose. I want to tighten the trucks because it's just way too loose for my taste because it's just so wobbly. So we're gonna tighten the trucks and oh crap, I don't want to get any junk on this thing. So I'm gonna come in here with the skate tool and we're just gonna tighten the trucks down. I'm gonna tighten them down a lot actually. This just makes the deck way more stable. And we'll tighten the back one too. One. And what I do normally is I kind of look at the thread, like right here there's about, I don't know, 3-4 turns in the front, there's not. So I need to tighten down the front a lot more so it looks visually the same as the back. And what we're doing is we're just putting pressure on the bushing that's below this. So those look about the same. Yeah, that's super tight. All right, let's try it out. I gotta be careful here. I don't want to get paint on this. I don't know if the bottom of my feet have spray paint on them. Let's see. Yeah, that's way better. So cool. There you go. So that was our little skate break. We got new bearings and we tightened our trucks. Pretty awesome though. I look at this thing and I can't believe I have it. It's so sick. All right, guys. So we're gonna let this dry and then we'll come back. And I'm not sure how much more we're actually gonna do in this video because really I just need to put the control panel back together. Okay, and all those parts are drying. I'm gonna have to order more buttons. I don't think we're gonna end up using those buttons. I think those buttons are hosed. So let me think about how much more we're gonna do and we'll be back. All right, guys, we got the tumbler going. We have this stuff drying. I actually put a little bit more of that liquid metal on here. You could see that there. But it looks kind of ugly right now. That's okay. I built it up a little bit more. We'll let that dry overnight, and then I'll sand it in the next video. Yes, in the next video. We're going to end right now, actually, because I need to let all this stuff sit. I can't really do anything with it. I need to have that go for probably at least 2 days. To clean up all the little screws and stuff that are rusty on there. I want this stuff to dry overnight before I even attempt to sand it. And then this stuff over here, I've already got like 2 or 3 coats on the back side. I'm gonna let that dry for an hour. I'm gonna flip it over and I'll put another 2 or 3 coats on there. And then this plate over here, which we need to put the control panel back together, I've already got 2 coats of blue on there. I'm gonna let that dry for about an hour, flip it over, and then do another 2 coats of blue. But that's looking actually pretty good. And then over here, I mean, the control panels, and then actually over here, I've got all these parts soaking, okay? So all that stuff is soaking in our kind of simple green bleach mixture. I'm gonna let that soak overnight. And then we have our control panel that's just kind of sitting here waiting to be put back together. But I gotta tell you, I've been admiring this thing. Because it actually looks great. The colors are popping. The joystick looks good. So this is going to look really sharp when we get done. But we can't put it back together yet because all the parts are soaking. And we need that blue plate to go on here, which needs a few more coats of paint. So we're going to stop right here. And then in the next video, we'll finish all this stuff that we started. And I think in the next video, we'll probably start right away with the coin door. We'll sand all this and then paint it. And then let that dry. And then we'll start attacking the blue on this cabinet here. And we're going to have to do some Bondo work first in the next video. Actually, the edges are actually not too bad on this cabinet, but we should sharpen them up. We're going to have to remove the jump bug side art, okay? I need to take the whole game apart, take the monitor out, and spray paint all the blue. Let that dry. You know, we're going to have to sand the sides and prep them for our laminate because I'm going to use white vertical grade laminate on the sides. I actually need to figure out where to buy it, but that's the plan. So anyway, why don't we stop here, guys, and we'll resume this all in the next video. So Why don't we go back down to the basement and let's do some viewer mail. Does that sound fun? We didn't do any viewer mail in the last video because it was so long. I'm not sure how long this video is. Is it long? It feels long. So anyway, let's go back down to the basement and let's do some viewer mail and hang out a little bit more. So, all right, guys, let's go. Are you excited, though? It's looking good. Is it looking good? It's gonna look good. All right, let's go back down to the basement. All right, guys, there you have it. That was part number 5 of the jump bug restoration. I hope you guys enjoyed that, huh? A lot of stuff we started in this video. We didn't necessarily finish it. We'll finish it in the next video because I really need to get back out there like soon. I'm actually kind of eager to finish the coin door because we kind of left that as a hanging thing. And we also need to take care of all those little plastic parts that are soaking and all that stuff. So we'll do that very soon. And really, I started filming this video on Saturday instead of waiting until Sunday. And I'm gonna be back in that mode like I was with the journey where I'm kind of filming throughout the week and then releasing the video in a timely manner on Sunday because honestly, I'm into this right now. I cannot wait to get back out there. I'll probably be out there Monday, Tuesday night working on stuff and filming. So we're in full mode right now, guys, full restore mode. Anyway, I know this video is kind of long and I wanna quickly blast through some viewer mails. And by the way, if you guys wanna participate in the viewer mail segment, you need to email them to me at blkdog7@gmail.com, blackdog7@gmail.com. So if you guys get any questions or comments or you need advice, whatever, no question is stupid, just email them to blackdog7@gmail.com. All right, first one here is from Carl. Hey John, long time watcher here. You got a sweet show, man. Thanks for all your hard work, time, and effort that goes into making each and every episode. Thank you. I attached a couple of photos. Can you verify the type of joysticks on this control panel? Are they Wico? It's a 1984 Belly Sente hat trick, okay? I'm missing one ball top. I'd like to get new ball tops and where would be a good place to find them? I'd like to meet you at Grinker's this October. Keep it real, Carl. So Carl sent some photos here that I printed out and they're kind of small. I don't know if you guys can see that. Carl, these joysticks to me look like Monroe joysticks, okay? And these are the same joysticks that you'll find on Gyrus and Time Pilot. I believe Rampage uses these joysticks too. And I'll come back here, I'll show you guys. On the Gyrus here, that pretty much looks like the joystick you're showing. So that's a Monroe style stick that kind of gives a full 360 degrees. It's a great stick. It has a very distinct feel to it. And again, this joystick's very common on Gyrus and Time Pilot, and I'm pretty sure Rampage also uses that joystick. So yeah, I would say that's a Monroe. Now, as far as where to get a replacement ball, I mean, I don't know, man. You'd have to probably check eBay a lot and maybe try to find a Gyrus or Time Pilot control panel. I actually did a little research for you too. I'm not sure, are those the original joysticks? Did they originally release it with those joysticks? I wasn't aware of that because the pictures I saw online look like 8-way Wico joysticks with a big red ball. But that looks pretty original in your photo, so I'm not really sure what's going on there. I have to admit, I don't know everything about Belly Sente. Belly Sente is actually kind of cool company. It was like a company that that Nolan Bushnell started after he closed down Atari, actually after he sold Atari, and he had like a non-compete, and he wasn't really supposed to be doing it, and the company he created was Belly Sente, and they have some pretty cool games. But anyway, Hattrick is one of them. It's a hockey game. And so yeah, to me, those are look like Monroe joysticks. And I would probably search on eBay for Time Pilot or Gyrus control panels, because those are gonna be a lot more common than trying to find a Belly Sente control panel. And also just search for Monroe joystick. I know Claw would be a great source for that too. You might wanna post a wanted to buy. All right, so the next one here is from Nick. Hey John, I have a Sega Altered Beast arcade cabinet that was converted from a Joust. I've had it for 2 years now, but I hardly ever find anything about it online. Never had a problem over the 15 years I've owned it. Monitor's great and everything. Is it a rare game? I'd like to know, have I read this email before? This is starting to sound familiar. Did I read this one before? I don't know. I'd like to know what you think about this game as well. I feel like I did read this email before. John is losing it. I don't know. So Altered Beast, well, that was a game I remember on the Genesis. That was like a launch title. And yes, there was an arcade version of Altered Beast. It seems to me that it was released in a kit form, okay? And I have seen my share of Altered Beasts. It's a pretty neat game. I don't think I would consider it rare. And it's usually a conversion kit that's in some other cabinet like your Joust. So, cool game. I remember it making a pretty big impression on me when it came out on the Genesis. I remember going to Kmart and they had the Genesis hooked up like right when it released, and it had like a demo of the game and you could play it. And yeah, it was a pretty elite game back in the day. I personally wouldn't seek it out. You know, those side-scrolling beat 'em up games to me don't have a lot of replay value because there is like an ending, and it's I know a lot of these games are very repetitive. You know, I know that this game isn't very deep, really, but Altered Beasts, that very linear gameplay, where you're not necessarily going for high score, you're trying to get to the end, those kind of games don't really last for me for a long time. Next one here is from Mark. Not really a question, just more of a comment or so. Hi, John. Do you remember the pictures of the centipede machine and the black cabaret machine I sent you? I'm very proud of them, but what I have been really wanting to do is get stuck into fixing or restoring an old machine that was there at the time. I've finally done it. I bought a 1978 Bally Midway Space Invaders upright for £50, which is probably what, like $100 US or something, 75? The black and white Wells Gardner monitor is all there, so is the power supply and the PCB. I've already contacted Bob Roberts and have asked, he's asked me to email some pics of the monitor, chassis, and power supply so I can order the necessary parts to rebuild it. I just want to say thanks, because if it wasn't for you and your videos, I wouldn't have heard of Bob Roberts or feel confident to tackle this restoration. So thanks again. Can't wait to see more of the computer space videos, and I will keep you updated on my Space Invaders restoration. All the best, Mark Hato. So yeah, not necessarily a question. I just thought it was a nice email. So Mark felt confident to take on the Space Invaders because of the videos, and he's now working with Bob Roberts to get the monitor fixed. So that's super cool. I'm excited for you, Mark. You know, Space Invaders, that is a very iconic and classic game. So enjoy the restore, because this hobby is awesome, isn't it? It's so fun. You get to work on so many things, you know, like artwork and painting and electronics and cleaning and restoring. And there's just so many facets to this hobby. So I hope you really enjoy it, because I love it. So anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I'm trying to go as fast as I can, so this video is not 2 hours long. So anyway, again, if you guys want to participate in the viewer mail segment, please email them to me at blkdog7@gmail.com. And again, our tournament May 29th and 30th, Greg from Arcade Impossible is going to be there. Sean Fetish Boy from Arcade Outsiders, myself, Matt McCarthy from the Kill Screens. We're all going to be at Fun Spot May 29th and 30th. We're having a tournament. It's an arcade tournament. It's very official. We're going to have a referee there recording the scores. Everything you need to know is at johnsarcade.com. So check it out. I really hope some of you guys can make it, because I really want to meet some of you guys. So show up, and I guarantee you, it's going to be a good time. So anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I'll see you guys very soon. I want to do a video like on Wednesday, a laser guy video. I have a laser game I want to play on Wednesday. So maybe we'll do that on Wednesday or Thursday. So, and then probably next weekend we'll be back in the garage to keep going on that jump bug. So anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe, like, tell your friends, all that good stuff. All right, later, and bye.